Hello everyone. In the last two lectures, we have studied about what is balancing of rotating masses, what are the various types of balancing, and what is the difference between static and dynamic balancing. And as in the previous lecture, we have studied about the introduction to balancing cases in rotating masses. So we have seen that basically for a subject point of view, we have four different types of cases which are important, that is balancing of single mass in same plane and balancing of single mass in different planes. In the same way, balancing of different masses in different planes and balancing of different masses in same plane. So let's first start with balancing of single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in same plane. That is, we'll discuss case first. So case one is balancing of single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in the same plane. In this, we have a single disturbing mass which is to be balanced by a single balancing mass, and they both are rotating on the same plane. That is a problem of static balancing. So here we have to balance the centrifugal forces. So let's consider, say this x represents the axis of rotation. So consider a disturbing mass M1 which is attached to a shaft rotating at omega radian per second. So we have mass M1 which is a disturbing mass which is attached to a shaft which is rotating at omega radian per second, as you can see in this figure. So let R1 is the radius of rotation of mass M1, that is R1 is the distance between the axis of rotation of the shaft and center of gravity of the mass M1. So this R1 represents the distance between the axis of rotation of the shaft and center of gravity, or we can say center of this rotating mass M1. Now this mass M1 at a radial distance R1, which is rotating with angular velocity omega radian per second, will have certain centrifugal force. So the centrifugal force exerted by mass M1 on the shaft is given by, say, FC1. It is equals to M1 R1 omega square, where M1 is the mass of the disturbing component, R1 is the radial distance between the axis of rotation of the shaft and center of gravity of the mass M1, and omega is the speed in radian per second with which the shaft is rotating. So centrifugal force is M1 R1 omega square, and it is acting radially outwards to the axis of rotation. Now this force acts radially outwards and produces bending moment on the shaft, as we have already discussed in the first lecture. So this centrifugal force, which has a magnitude M1 R1 omega square, acts radially outwards and it produces bending moment on the shaft. Now in order to counteract the effect of this force, we have clearly written, in order to counteract the effect of this force, that is FC1, a balancing mass M2 at a radial distance R2 producing force FC2. This FC2 will have magnitude M2 R2 omega square, may be attached in the same plane of rotation of the disturbing mass M1, such that the centrifugal forces due to the two masses are equal and opposite. In this context, everything is very clearly mentioned. That is, the force due to this disturbing mass should be balanced by the balancing mass, which has a magnitude M2 and it is placed at a radial distance of R2 from the axis of rotation in the same plane. That is, we have a balancing mass of magnitude M2 which is placed at a radial distance of R2 from the axis of rotation and produces the centrifugal effect FC2, which acts radially outwards in the direction opposite to FC1, such that we have the same configuration, that is M1 which is the disturbing mass, M2 which is the balancing mass. As the centrifugal forces exerted by mass m1 on the shaft at radius r1 is given by m1 r1 omega square. It is denoted at fc1. Let it be question 1. In the same way, the centrifugal force exerted by mass m2 on the shaft at radius r2 is given by fc2, which is m2 r2 omega square. And for balancing, this equation 1 should be equals to this equation 2, that is from first and second, m1 r1 omega square is equals to m2 r2 omega square. Here we have taken the common rotation, that is the speed of the shaft is taken common, that is omega radian per second. So from first and second, we can say that m1 r1 should be equals to m2 r2, which is the required condition for balancing of single rotating mass by a single mass rotating in same plane. Clear? So if m1 r1 equals to m2 r2, we can say that the rotating mass are statically balanced, which are on the same plane and is been balanced by a single mass of magnitude m2 at a radial distance r2. Hope you are clear. Thank you so much. For more videos, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Gagan Bansal. Or for any query, you can directly mail me at gaganbansal12345@gmail.com. Thank you so much.